Smart Wargames hier. Let's do a Harpoon Guide. Yeah, give me a moment to get into my chat. Sound check. Okay, good. Yeah, Harpoon. You could say it is basically the grandfather of Command or of CMO. And yeah, it was quite a revolutionary game, and it had I don't know what, how many releases and re-releases. From a technical standpoint, to get things straight, I don't see any reason, at least for me, I don't see any reason to play Harpoon or to favor Harpoon compared to CMO. Absolutely see no reason. But again, same with Fleet Command, there's a ton of scenarios or so-called battle sets released for Harpoon, and there's still a community that is releasing updates to this very day, or at least to 2000 to recent months. And perhaps there's a campaign, a battle set which you really enjoy. Same for me, you know, if I would have a re-engaging campaign, I would play Harpoon, you know, because the campaign is exciting, or the story, or the battle set. Okay, I will give you a short guide how to get started if you want to get into it. There is a, you can get the Ultimate Edition on Matrix Games, which includes a lot of versions. Then get those two update packages here. Good, and yeah, you will end up with a setup file. Run everything as administrator. Yeah, right click on the exe, run as admin. That is very important. You will have to enter your serial key, which you received when you buy at Matrix. And first you will need to define a folder. I might myself struggled somewhat, made some installation errors because it is somewhat convoluted installation process. First you will design. First thing, you need to select a location or to create a folder. I would call it something like Harpoon Ultimate Edition, and the setup tool will unpack all those installation tools into this folder and then execute them one by one for those single Harpoon versions. So watch out that you don't end up with, I don't know, 5 Harpoon games thrown into one folder. I mean, could be possible, but it's I guess not really practical. So first design this folder, and then I don't know, the setup installation starts Harpoon 3.3.6.3, yeah, and then I don't know, create a folder, that's my name's Harpoon 3 version 3.6.3. So yeah, you will end up with 4 versions. Can be also a bit complicated which version is what. I made a video on my channel where I showcase quickly how those 4 versions look like. I'm not an expert on the history of Harpoon, but from what I get, I give you the basics. Harpoon 3.3.6.3 is a very popular basic version of Harpoon 3. Yeah, that is, it might have limited display options for modern systems. A second popular edition is Harpoon 3.3.9.4, also called, at least I think it's called, Advanced Naval Warfare. Also popular, perhaps not in the old school community, not that popular like the classic Harpoon 3, but this comes with, at least I found, perhaps you can also do some editing here, but this comes with dedicated Windows settings, allowing you to get also a proper displaying on, for example, widescreen full HD displays. Then there's a Harpoon Ultimate Commander's Edition, which I think is a remaster of the original Harpoon Classic. Also not Harpoon 3, but Harpoon 1 or 2. Yeah, check out the other video, it looks okay. It looks graphically even very great if you're into that. I heard it is still very, that some play it in multiplayer. Then we have Harpoon 3 Ultimate Edition or Ultimate Admiral's Edition Advanced Naval Warfare, which might be either some sort of minor modification of 394. Yeah, didn't found that much out about this version. If you know, you can let me know in the comment. This will be also installed. Yeah, that's the four versions. And to play, you got the game. Then there are some community sites I found still active, for example this here, where you can also get database. Database are basically some sort of, yeah, it contains units, weapon values, stuff like this. And yeah, this, at least I've read somewhere that this might be one of the most popular ones, this PlayerDB. And there's three. This one, ANW, is for 394. This normal one is for Harpoon 3, 363. And Harpoon Ultimate Edition, yeah, Arabic Emirates. Yeah, that's, I wanted to name it like this. That is for this one here. And they all contain already a huge pack of scenarios. Yeah, those databases, they are not that big, but they contain. So look up what are the difference between those three. There might be some minor differences when it comes to handling of specific stuff, and then you can, but not all scenarios are available in all versions. And yeah, if you go here on scenarios, you will have again, exactly, again, it seems the community called this here, that is basically basic 363, that here is 394, Huey is this Ultimate Edition Harpoon 3. And yeah, I mean, I've opened those three pages up. It comes with a lot of battle sets. And you see there are some differences. A lot of shared, but some not. Looks like the mastery for this classic Harpoon 3. You can read there about the background. Some are quite new, 2016. And this has the least. But there might be even some unique ones. Yeah, perhaps this has some unique ones. No, it hasn't. So check it out. Yeah, a lot of scenarios for all your needs, Cold War, whatever. Then there's this monster size scenarios, which is also somewhere a link. I also installed it. It is either, yeah, for, again, for classic Harpoon 3 or for Harpoon 3 363 or for ANW, which is 394. I think, you know, this was the versions a bit, but looks like also the naming, they made it, but you, once you figure it out, it's okay. Yeah, so this huge monster size scenario is for those two versions. And yeah, there's even a form I found which is still active, and quite interesting missions here to be found. Historical NATO exercises. Dynamic Mongoose is a naval, is a true naval exercise, which was, which really was commenced. So somebody might recreated it in Harpoon, and other NATO exercise or missions based on current operations. Good. That's about what you can get for this game. Yeah, let's get into the game. I will play 394 for this, because simply because of the screen thing. It's a set 363. I don't see. I mean, if you hit this autorun exe, you don't have. But could be that there's somewhere in game, or that you can modify some ini file. But here you have this 394 or Advanced Naval Warfare. It seems it's called in the community. You can hit this configuration and here, set run that windowed and stretch it out. It will fill your screen. You will have a lot of space to work with. Yeah. And select the database. Yeah, there are several databases. This game had really a lot of stuff going on. And there are a lot of databases. Those three ship with the game. And I think databases might ship with their own missions. So if you install this game, check out those different databases. Perhaps contain more content. Yeah, quantity-wise, there's definitely enough to scenarios. Yeah, but same as with CMO. Yeah, select this. If you want to play the PlayerDB, and most of the scenarios you saw there are based on PlayerDB, as far as I understand. And other than that, yeah, this setting here is really helpful. As I said, you can set this to high, and then let's skip the video. You will get a quite big screen to work with. Yeah, I want to do some ASW, simply to see how submarines have some fast submarine action. Let's hit some classic geoc gap and watch. Look for some submarines. So it looks like it is currently some sort of Cold War World War III situation, and we simply need to catch and kill, yeah, player database. Player's database. Okay, let's go. We will take NATO. Let's get the screen into shape. Yeah, there's a limitation to the tactical screen, I guess 1200 or whatever, then it's... So you can't max it out, but at least you have space for your tools, which is better than from what I've seen sometimes, which would be way too... Yeah, then you can set preferences. This, what you see here, is depth and elevation can be helpful, of course, especially in sub-hunting, but I think we can also remove it. Yeah, this, and when it comes to graphics, it's similar like DEFCON. You can basically define the colors as you want. One interesting thing might be this. Yeah, there are some default palettes. Aegis display. Interesting why they call it like this. Aegis is this. Perhaps those Aegis compatible US ships have a similar screen color, but I think currently I'm more happy with this. Okay, yeah, we have two task forces here, Task Force Manchester and SAM. And I guess this is the gap we need to patrol and to secure. We can start already the game, at least. What is the time compression? Let's go on 1 second. Okay, game is running. Yeah, let's... Can I see the single ships? Didn't I set it to... Oh, okay, that is somewhat hard on the eyes. Whoa. Perhaps I stick to the other screen. To the other colors. What do we have as amber? Why not? Yeah, weapon ranges, please. Yeah, you will notice some many similarities between Command and Harpoon, because Harpoon, of course, is like I said, was the... Good. I just wonder, is there a way to show single ships? Ah, hier. Communication Center, Calvin, Steve V. Groves. Okay. And those guys have, yeah, you need to double click this. I think you can remove this. This is a safety that you buy, not by accident, remove those screens, but that can be rather annoying. We have a C-Sprite and a Seahawk there. Okay. Yeah, so let's do some classic. Let's add two reference points. Perhaps. Okay, mission called Seavent created, and that was a SEM at aircraft. It's a quick way to find it out where it is on FF Ariadne. Yeah, here. No, that's not the numbers. Why are they both carrying the same designation? Royal Navy 8282. Is that correct? They should have two different. But this guy is... Lynx is out of ammo. Okay, quickly check what was the contents of this group. Caron, okay, those two helos. What they carry, that's fine. MK-46 torpedoes and I guess sonos. Sono buoys. Good. Seavent has two helos. And the rest we will add to the other mission. Sam has no orders. Now you have orders. Good. Sam is moving into the area, and yeah, that is of course a bit too big, but you can move it. We want to have a barrier, not an area. In order to step bypassing submarines. Let's add two new reference points. The question is, do we really want to... I mean, it can be helpful to have two, but... either focus on a narrow point or have two barriers, but this is of course an area which can also do something like this. But it would take a lot of time, so let's focus on this here, one reference point. Another one. What the heck? What is he doing? Why did you even change it? Meine Güte. Was not even in the mission screen. Yeah, for some reason I lost this reference point here. Curse the area. Yeah, thanks. Okay. I guess it has something to do that the mission is still selected. Yeah, now it's working out. Okay, and Manchester. Why is there only one helo unassigned? Then we had two. Yeah, what happened to the second helo? We had two helos, but one helo did he. We will check it out. Something is wrong with one helo. Ah, exactly, yeah. Yeah, we will definitely go sonar on, ECM no, sonar on, active intercepted is. This area is way too big, but this will do also turn it into a barrier. Okay. Set them to cruise. Okay, one helo is operating. We will of course speed up the game to is plus and minus to 15 seconds or whatever. Let's check what is going on with the second helo. And yeah, the colors are also not my thing. Let's change it. What do we have as? Oh, this looks good. Is that standard? No, it looks more colorful. Yeah, no, this is really good. This thing I like. It's grayscale. And it's a Game Boy mode. That's a great harpoon on Game Boy. Man, I mean, why not? That would be a thing. Yeah, but this was great. This QG663. I guess it's also too crazy on my eyes currently. Perfect. What the heck are you doing with those Sono boys? Who's deploying them like this? Who is this? There's not even a Hilo.
Yeah, the Hilo is too...
Who is this? Is... Are they firing them?
This is Alpha X-Ray. New subcontact, over.
A subcontact? Pause. How do we pause in this game? P? Go, read time. Subcontact. Here. Hilo. Hilo. Prosecute. I currently have a lot of information on the screen, but I always need... I think he's already prosecuting him. Yeah. Oh man, I'm on a 1 minute. But he's already prosecuting him. Or trying to identify him. Yeah, I mean, we can remove some stuff. Like, anti-surface, anti-air is currently not important. And then the screen updates. Okay, so one Hilo found a sub. I just wonder where those Sonar Boys are coming from. One Hilo is here, one Hilo is here. It looks like it's the surface group is firing those Sonar Boys, or is there some Hilo operating I don't see? Yeah, I would also rather like that they deploy it into this zone here. That works quite good in command if you design a zone small, but okay. It's fine. Let's see, those guys are on active sonar, active radar. I don't know. No, go passive radar. Let the Hilo handle radar. On the other hand, yeah, but it's safer, it's safer. Surface ships, you know, they can be targeted by cruise missiles from subs. Sure, the Hilos can be identified via ESM, but at least they can't be targeted by cruise missiles. Here go also active sonars, comlink, sure. Okay. So he's already engaging. Slow down to free time. What is it for a sub? Goblin, unknown. Okay. Oh, he dropped a torp. Stingray, torpedo in the water. Okay. Yeah, same for you. You can go radars active on the sonars. Surface group is... I guess I have something investigated, whatever, but it's fine. I mean, without looking outside of this area, we wouldn't have found the sub. Yeah, go passive on radars, active sonars, pass...
Alpha Bravo, this is Alpha X-Ray, new subcontact, over.
Oh, new subcontact. How the heck are you detecting them? It's magic or what? Acoustic very strong. Okay, he's that loud. I mean, if he's flank speeding there, I still think it's somewhat magic here. The distance, you know, the geo gap is not big, but okay. Yeah, I mean, perhaps there's a Zosus already in. We receive information from zoners that are already in place. Perhaps I will give this Hilo a manual order then. What is he doing? Hilo, what are you doing currently? Cruising. What the heck are those guys doing with the Sonar Boy army? Yeah, it looks like the ship is... Yeah, this is a group. This is a group of ships heading, I guess, like this, and they're dropping Sonar Boys. It's okay, I mean, it's quite, but you see, they do it properly, so that there's no way that something sure would be greater if you can do it like this, I guess with... Okay, a second Hilo launches somewhere, that is good. What is this? Torpedo, boat, TB, torp. Who the heck launches torpedoes into this? And did this guy survive? Yeah, okay, I get this guy. What is with this guy? Detection time is... This guy went off. Could be that this post sub is down. We have no confirmation that it is destroyed, but detect time is very old. Okay. I guess to this is this one mission set with Sono Boys. Yeah, sure it is. Yeah, I mean, sure, prosecute him. Ah, yeah, perfect, get the healer out there. Did he found him? I don't know if the tag time means... Yeah, it has to be, because he's updating the contact. Submarines are very easy detected here. I'd like to know what it is. Yeah, what was it? Yeah, could be that I have some AI assist activated. There's some AI assist in this game because it looks like he shifted some helos over to this area, but I'm not sure. Okay. But is he deploying Sono Boys? What is he doing there? Simply doing a barrier search, or we don't. Could be that we don't see Hilo Sono Boys, but those guys are definitely Sono Boys fans. I mean, two were deployed here, two defas. I guess it was a Hilo. Good. Yeah. Currently, what is this torpedo Stingray? Is it active? We don't know. We don't know where the torpedo is. There's a setting which you can set so that you always know where your weapons are, but in full realism you don't know about your weapons either. Except you're tracking them. This guy is trying to find the other sub. This guy not even have a dipping sonar, nothing. He's only an MRD search. No sonars, but Sono Boys, yeah, right. Okay, keep this window open. It's not updating. Otherwise it would be cool to keep this around, but it's not updating. Okay, he's pinpointing it. I don't know how he is doing it, but somehow they do it. Perhaps Hilo or Sonoboys are abstracted from the display. I don't know. Let's speed up the game. I mean, he has a lot of waypoints, you see. There must be a reason why he's plotting so many waypoints. But like I said, MRD is normally not used as a primary detection. From what I've read, MRD is used for target, for finalization, confirmation, prior attacking. Sono boys, it is. But could be that we are receiving some information. You know, there is. In those geo gaps, there is those already pre-installed sonar arrays.
Alpha Bravo, this is Alpha X-ray, subcontact lost, over.
What is 3 helos here, 1-0 helos there? What happened to this helo? Was it shot down? Yeah, it could be. There's a setting here. Staff handles weapon allocation, treat access formations, whatever. Formation air patrols. Could be that this is somehow manipulating what I am designing here. Because it wonders me, some of those helos seem to be either this helo landed here, or he is in this group and we don't see it. As we see again this barrier. And Sonoboy is getting removed.
Alpha Bravo, this is Alpha.
Could be that there's some AI access currently going on. But you can deactivate it. No aircraft available. So all aircraft are here, what? Okay, did they got their sub finally? Goblin 7. Very large sub contact lost. Good. I guess this guy is gone. Heading home, reached bingo fuel. Okay. Time compression. What? Links has detached from task group Manchester. Order to land. Do I need to re-equip them myself manually? No. They are soon ready. Yeah, there must be something that you sometimes don't see those helos when they are with the group, because this is a group symbol. Maybe that this is the helo doing it, but you don't see them from. Guess when there's some reason and they detach from the group, I guess via AI assist you might see them on the screen. Otherwise, the helo is basically included in this group. You have something similar in command, but without air units being integrated. I guess these are helos doing this job here. They are basically screening the group, which is normally quite a smart thing to do. It's okay, because I already see stuff happening. But I don't know, normally this is of course in bigger scenarios this is good, when everything is basically integrated into one group, you have an uncluttered screen, but right now I would like to see every single unit on the map. Not sure where this setting is. These videos you can also disable. There is in the preferences in the beginning, there is a setting group view, single unit view, similar to CMO. I set it to single unit view, but yep, exactly. You see here are the helos and the ships in close range. You can do a formation editor where you can move units. That is basically current which group? This here. That is a close zoom. You can also activate it for the tactical screen. Yeah, wait, I will get rid of those videos. Got some command center here going on. I like it. What is PZ? Is this somewhere? No. CPU, whatever. Where did I find the screen? Here somewhere, right? It's this thing here. What do we have else? It's this here. This is weapon launch or attack. This is sonars. This is navigation. This is dev settings, speed settings, aircraft. Okay, ASW, all these red things here. This is not updating. So I need for this thing another. Yes, give me information. Give me information, please. I like it. I want to be informed about everything. I want real time information about everything. Give me every group formation, real time command center here, please. Yeah, because I can't. It seems the window can't. isn't switching on mouse click. But I like it, it feels really like some... He's sitting in some command center here. I guess cruiser on command center. Good, it's 1 minute time compression. Yeah, this is a long scenario. I won't play it completely. I think you are. This is going 3 days. Time compression is fine. Let's see what we can max it out. Yeah, this is not bad. Look at this. So in 3 days, you can pass them quickly. minutes compression. He isn't hitting those 30 minutes, but he's trying. But you can definitely get some time compressed here. Yeah, the tactics we use currently are not the best. Sure, it would be better if the helo deploys. Perhaps you can do it with some editor. The helo is currently basically... wait, I need to get the sound a bit lower. Also, I suffer tinnitus from this clicking sounds. Who is clicking? Okay. yeah, I don't know if there are some tactics. Perhaps mission edit. Wait, I added a mission. Let's see, create mission. Substrike patrol ASW. Focus strike could. Recon ship report. Because it looks like it could be that it's those AI assists that they force the helos to focus securing those ships. Yeah, so this is a doctrine thing. Once a ship enters the ASW area, helos or all ASW assets will focus on protecting those ships. What? Somebody exploded, man, faster. Yeah, wait, some submarine exploded. What was it? I was a bit too hardcore in the... Who exploded? Was it one of our ships? Large sub kilo. Kilo exploded. Method, radar, infantry... Yeah, okay. Infrared, passive sonar, MRD. Positive ID. Method, radar, infrared. How the heck did you detect him with radar? A kilo? With radar? Was he simply cruising here, surfaced? Perhaps he ran out of batteries. Or had the snorkel out. Periscope. I mean, it's possible to detect stuff like periscope or whatever. There's surface radars that can detect reflections of stuff like periscopes, snorkels. Yeah, I guess this kilo blow up happens. Perhaps 30 minutes is too brutal. Give me 50 minutes. I guess detaching those aircraft from those, but something, there's something going on. I think it's this AI assist. This here. What? Failed. Here, formation air patrols. I think that is informations. Those two things you might want to remove in order to have more control. Okay. That so many, yeah, I guess that was not a good barrier, of course. Yeah, let's take a look. What? Lynx violate its rule of engagement when it fired at Goblin 7. Yeah, but why is it my problem? I'm the pilot of Lynx 7. Ask the pilot, not me. I'm a superior commander. I didn't see anything, guys. Yeah, looks like because I guess he didn't post ID'd it, but he ID'd it as hostile. Could be that the mission requires you to ID them. Destroy 5 units. How many did we destroy? 3. And we got this violation here and need now to go in front of court and explain ourselves. All losses. Perhaps you only 1 kilo. So the other 2 submarines escaped. Interesting, those submarines are quite... Only this kilo blew up. The thing where we were thinking that we managed, they escaped. That's interesting, I like it, that the subs survived this. Can I see all... Can I see the... That's also what I'm missing, command, that you can't see a proper after action report of the complete screen, I think. Simply resume. No, I need to quit. It's not possible to check the screen. Yeah, I mean, that was basically a short showcase. You see, you can still play it quite straightforward on even on modern systems, Windows 10. Keep those installation. Advice, the installation advice in mind. And yeah, get the settings done, read the manual, perhaps it explains everything. Okay. Yeah, it was great to check it out again.